Om Shanti. This is the Avyakta Murli of 10th December 1978 in the series of Power of Thought. Nowadays, very clear picture of any place can be seen in many different places. So Madhuban is also a TV station. There are TV sets everywhere. Nowadays, scientists are able to measure the speed of thoughts and check the state of someone's mind. Similarly, the thoughts and vibration of the mind of the residents of Madhuban spread everywhere. Therefore, you should pay attention to your every thought, to every thought you have. You should not be careless about this. If you, residents of Madhuban, want to spread your vibration of special thought while sitting in Madhuban, then you are able to sit somewhere and do that. Just as the fragrance of something physical automatically spreads everywhere, similarly the vibration of huge thoughts, your thoughts should automatically spread everywhere. This is the special service that the residents of Madhuban have to do. When you have a special bhatti in Madhuban, those vibrations spread everywhere. So this is the Avyakta Murli of 1978. Baba is saying that Madhuban is TV station. Whatever you think here, your thoughts spread around. In mobile, there is a very good app. One book is available in the form of app. And I think everybody can download that book. The name of the book is Thought Vibration by Dr. Atkinson. Thought Vibrations. It's easily available free. That book is describing the role of... This book is not written by a person who is too much religious or spiritualist, but who is more of a scientist, who is more of a philosopher. So that book is describing complete different theories of laws of attraction, theories of thought vibrations, how the thought spreads from one place to another place. He is describing the whole world as an ocean of thoughts. And just as in the physical ocean, you have one wave linked with another wave, in the similar manner, one thought is automatically linked with other thoughts of similar nature, of similar wavelengths. So whatever you think, you are attracting the similar thoughts. If you are thinking that, yes, today is a very pleasant day, today is a very pleasant day, so you will attract the thoughts of that pleasant day. And that happiness will become your own happiness. If you have the thought that I am sick, I am sick, I am sick, I am sick, so you are attracting thoughts of illness, disease. There's a very good example of a person given somewhere. There was a person and he used to get affected by what others say. Very often, quite often. So what happened one day? He was a professor in some college. One of his students, he played a trick. What he did? He went to his house, and whilst that professor was sleeping, the student, college student, he talked with the wife of that professor and he told him, I am going to do one experiment. Please cooperate. This is a psychological experiment. He told his wife, the moment your husband gets up, tell him, are you alright? You are looking pale. You are looking weak. Did you sleep properly at night? She said, why should I say this? He said, just say this to him. The moment he gets up. Then he caught hold of the servant of that place, of that professor's house, and he told him, the moment you see your master, ask him, are you all right? You are not looking well. Why are you going to college today? Take rest. And then this student talked with the gardener of that house, and he told him, ki, I am doing one experiment. The moment you see that your master is sitting in the car, tell him that, oh, you are not looking well. Please take rest. And then this student went to the office. There was a post office which was coming in between. And he told the postmaster that my professor passes through this way every day. The moment you see him today, tell him that you are looking very pale. Why are you traveling? You should take rest today, at least one day rest. And then he reached office, there was a peon there. And he told that peon, the moment your boss comes, hold him with the hand and take him inside so that he doesn't fall. Okay. So this man, this professor, gets up in the morning. He's very fresh after getting up, and his wife says, oh, why are you looking so pale? You're looking weak. Are you running some temperature? Did you sleep at night? He said, I am absolutely alright, I don't have any problem. I had a very good night, a sound sleep. I had no problem at all, no fever. Then he got ready and he was about to go and his servant is there. And his servant says, oh master, you are looking pale. Did you have good sleep? So he says, yeah, I had a disturbed sleep at night. His wife is seeing, he told his wife that I had a very good sleep. But now he is saying that I had little, my sleep was disturbed at night. Yeah, you are right. Then he goes out and whilst he is sitting in his car, gardener who is there, he says, oh boss, you are looking very pale. You are looking weak also. Did you sleep properly? Are you having some temperature? He says, yes, in the night I felt I had temperature. His wife is seeing, because he told his wife, I don't have temperature, I have no sleep, was okay. While he told his servant, I had a disturbed sleep. Now he is telling the gardener that I had a fever. Okay, then he goes. And while she is going near post office, the postmaster says, why did you come out today? You are looking so weak today. You go back home. He says, really I am not feeling well, but I had an important work. I'll just finish that 1 hour work and then go back and take rest. Then he reaches office. And by the time he reaches his office, the peon comes and he starts holding him. I think you will fall down. You are looking so pale. He says, really, please hold me nicely. I am about to fall. And he really, as he goes, he really feels as if he will fall down and they make him lie down. So, this is what is suggestions by others. This is what you think. Gradually, you start getting affected by the atmosphere outside. You start behaving in the similar manner as the hetero suggestions given by others. There are two types of suggestions in hypnosis. One is auto suggestions, which you give yourself, have self hypnosis. Other is when you give suggestions to others. In that book, The Power of Subconscious Mind, very good example Dr. Murphy has given, Joseph Murphy. He has given example of a person who is timid, who is very much afraid of traveling in ship because he feels that he will vomit, motion sickness. So one person sees him, that this person is quite afraid. He goes to him and he says, it seems as if you will vomit. It seems as if you are getting motion sickness. And that person really vomits. He really gets that because he had prepared his mind. His inside, he was so sensitive to hetero suggestion. The same thing happens. There is another person who rejects that suggestion. He says, no, I never get motion sickness. So it doesn't happen to him. So the conclusion is, whatever you think, similar thoughts you attract. And if you are sensitive to those thoughts, they start affecting you. If it is a negativity, then you have to raise a very strong positive thought so that you can counter all the negative thoughts. If it is a positive thought, then it has to be so strong that you remain unaffected by all the negativity which is around you. So this is the philosophy or theory of thought and vibrations. Whatever we think, that goes in the atmosphere, and whatever is in the atmosphere comes to us. Everything is interlinked. This is known as law of attraction. What I think goes in the atmosphere, reacts with the atmosphere, and situations are created. I am sick, I am sick, I am sick, I become sick. I am poor, I am poor, I am poor, I become poor. I am rich, I am rich, I am rich, I become rich. I am successful, I am successful, I become successful. I am angel of God. I become angel of God. I am master, almighty, authority. Yesterday's Mudli, we were discussing about statues, different statues, 32 statues, statues about angels. That was in the court of Emperor Vikramaditya. So one of the statues which we discussed yesterday was, I am Master Almighty Authority. All time authority, right? I am all time authority. So when I am Master, I am Master Son of Knowledge. I dispel darkness. I destroy all the rubbish, all the waste. And I bring light. Even a small lamp has a power to enlighten the entire room. So you cannot say that I cannot do. I alone cannot change. One person can change many persons, many, many people, the whole world. one person can move the world. That much power is there in one person. Because it is not the question of person, it is the question of thoughts. So thought has vibrations. Thought has got energy. Thought has got creative energy. Thought has got destructive energy. Thought can erect temples, edifices. Thoughts can destroy. It is the thought which is doing everything. It is the thought which is leading to constructions and destructions. So thoughts and their vibrations. So Baba is here talking with Madhuban Nivasis. Madhuban Nivasis is, Madhuban is a TV station. Whatever thoughts you have, if you have thoughts of purity, the same thoughts will reach the whole world. If you have thoughts of love, peace, happiness, harmony, the same thoughts will reach the world. If you have thoughts of waste, thoughts of vice, thoughts of negativity, the same thoughts will travel around. So, be very careful what I am thinking. Yesterday's Murli. In your thoughts, you have to become detached and loving. In your thoughts, while staying in the corporeal body, be incorporeal. These are the two things Baba told in thoughts. In your speech, you should have spiritual sweetness, and in your speech, you should have humility. From your forehead, when others see, they should be reminded of their original form. When you speak, they should be reminded of the details of creator and creation, and they should become, they should get the blessing of becoming from Brahmin to deity. From your hands, they should turn into easy yogi and karma yogi, and they should get fruit of elevated action. From your fruit, you follow father, and you give others the blessing of becoming multimillionaires. Multimillion time fortunate. From your eyes, you give them signal of their home and kingdom, and they should get the experience that this is my home, this is my real home, and this is my kingdom. So these are the 8 things. Plus 4 things, and then 5 more things. There should not be even a trace of vice in your thought, in your words, in your deeds, in your relationships, in your connections. So these are all the different things Baba told. Everything is so much linked to thoughts. Everything depends on that. Recently, 2 days back, there was a blessing in Murli. Thought is the basis of everything. Your thought is powerful, everything becomes powerful. Thought is the seed to have powerful action. Okay? So this was, so we need to understand more and more about thought power and thought vibrations. Everybody can download that book. It's in English. The name of the book is Thought Vibration, Atkinson. Yeah? Atkinson. You just type in Play Store, Thought Power, Thought Vibrations, immediately that book will come. And it's very simple English and very good book. Lot of theories are discussed and very much similar to what Baba has told. The theory of vibration. There are very few books on this. This is one of those few books. Thought Vibrations, Dr. Atkinson. Om Shanti.
Om Shanti. Good morning. So, power of thought. Today is Murli's date. It is 10-12-1978. So Baba says, nowadays, very clear pictures of any place can be seen in many different places. So Madhuban is also a TV station. There are TV sets everywhere. Nowadays, scientists are able to measure the speed of thoughts and check the state of someone's mind. Similarly, the thoughts and vibrations of the minds of the residents of Madhuban spread everywhere. Therefore, you should pay attention to every thought you have. You should not be careless about this. If you residents of Madhuban want to spread your vibrations of a special thought while sitting in Madhuban, then you are able to sit somewhere and do that. Just as the fragments of something physical automatically spread everywhere, similarly, the vibrations of your thoughts should automatically spread everywhere. This is the special service that residents of Madhuban have to do. When you have a special bhatti in Madhuban, those vibrations spread everywhere. So what Baba is saying here, nowadays very clear pictures of any place can be seen in many different places. So Madhuban is also a TV station. What are the other names of Madhuban Baba has told till now? That we'll revise. Lighthouse, Might House, Tower of Light, Tower of Peace, Tower of Purity, Tower of Knowledge. What else? Penance Place of Brahma, Palace of Glasses, Penance Place of Brahma, Tapasya Place of Brahma, Penance Place of Brahmins, Glass House. What else? Unlimited Place of Wash House, Laundry, Behad Ka Dhobi Ghat, how he says. Mall, Shop, Airport, Unlimited Airport, Beauty Parlor, ICU. Yeah, critically ill people come here to get the treatment, right? What is it? Is a showcase, and we are showpieces. Madhuban Nivasis are showpieces in Baba's showcase. What else? Anything else? Madhuban's name Baba has told. Real Ganga, Land of Sweetness, Powerful Lighthouse, Unlimited Home, Real Haridwar, Real Gurudwar, Tirth Yatra, Pilgrimage, biggest pilgrimage is Madhuban. So these are some of the names. Chetan Shivale. Okay. Real Temple. Real Dilwara. Yeah, Penance Place. Penance Place of Brahma, Penance Place of Brahmins. So these are some of the names of Madhuban. So today Baba is saying Madhuban is also a TV station. There are TV sets everywhere. Nowadays, scientists are able to measure the speed of thoughts and check the state of someone's mind. I was going through the literature, how the speed of thoughts are measured. Scientists are able to quantify the speed of light, the speed of sound, how the earth revolves around the sun. But thoughts are invisible. Thoughts cannot be seen. So how are they doing actually this process? So what they say, brain cells are known as neurons, and there is a complex network of neurons, and there is anything, if you want to find out the speed, you should know the beginning and the end of it. So there is exchange of network, exchange of energy between these neurons, and they capture whatever the active part of the brain is. So there are two things in that, through processes, two means investigations or techniques, that is known as fMRI, functional magnetic resonance imaging, and EEG, what we are, electroencephalography or encephalography, how you pronounce it. So EEG and fMRI are the two techniques where they capture the part of the brain which is active, and they capture what is generated between the neurons, and that's how they calculate the speed of thoughts. Now different experts have given their opinions that we create approximately 70 to 80,000 thoughts per day. So that comes to around 2,500 thoughts per hour. And some experts believe that we create 50,000 thoughts per day. So that comes to 2,100 thoughts per hour. So imagine we are creating so many thoughts in a day, so many thoughts per hour. And they have also gone through the data, and they believe that most of the thoughts are careless thoughts, useless, waste thoughts, and what Baba says, negative thoughts, meaningless thoughts. They are not elevated thoughts. But I was thinking that since we Brahmins read Murli every day, we do meditation every day, so our thoughts must be less than 50,000. And it should be. And if we want to be in the elevated state, we should create good thoughts, positive thoughts, elevated thoughts. Yeah. So I'm coming to that also. So So the level of thoughts what Brahmins are creating, Brahmins are generating, is less than the others. And I was just thinking that in Satyug we must be just having 15,000 to 20,000 thoughts per day, I think so. That's why we are in such elevated forms during that period. As sister said, in Gyan Sarovar, in Spark, where you keep the finger on that machine and there is a graph which is generated. And we come to know if we are in an elevated thought or the thoughts are less quality than the graph comes down. So some people describe that our mind is like a railway station, a busy railway station or an airport terminal where lot of people are coming and going. And same is our mind, where different and great thoughts are coming in a flow and going. And some people have described mind as a butterfly. Like butterfly does not sit at one place, it keeps on going from one place to another. Likewise, our thoughts are also the same, and the mind also has different thoughts which is coming and going. So here Baba is saying that these scientists are able to measure the speed of thoughts and check the state of someone's mind. Similarly, the thoughts and vibrations of the minds of the residents of Madhuban spread everywhere. So whatever thoughts we are creating goes to the outside world, goes to the environment where we are sitting. So I was thinking, till now in different murlis, Baba has given different examples. Like he has given example of like scented sticks, agarbatti. How he always tells that if there is an environment and there is a bad odor in that environment, and if you just light a scented sticks there, the entire fragrance spreads in the environment and the bad odor goes away. Likewise is the thought. If there are a lot of negativity in our environment, and if one positive person comes, the energy which he will generate will always be positive, and it creates a positive environment. Next example I was thinking is like thoughts are like perfume. What perfume we are wearing or what perfume we put, that odor, that fragrance is generated, that fragrance is emitted to a person who comes near us. Likewise, our thoughts are also the same. When we come in contact with somebody, there is exchange of thoughts. So there is exchange of energy. So like how perfume gives the fragrance, the thoughts also gives vibration. We all have experience that if some people are there, when they come in our company, we feel nice. And some people come in our company and we feel little, you know, ki I didn't feel the good vibes of this person, we say. So why we didn't feel the good vibes of that person? Because our thoughts are like that. So here Baba says that thoughts and vibrations of the minds of residents of Madhuban spread everywhere. Therefore, you should pay attention to every thought you have. That is why it becomes our great responsibility that if Madhuban Nivasis are creating negative thoughts, then it is passing to the entire world. So we should be in always positive, elevated, high energy thoughts. You should not be careless about this. If you residents of Madhuban want to spread your vibrations of a special thought while sitting in Madhuban, then you are able to sit somewhere and do that. Everybody here must be having an experience that if we have some situation in life and we do a special yoga for that, things change at our place. Like I had heard a sister's experience. She was from West Bengal or Bangladesh, I think, and she had come here for seva, and she had lot of problems at her home, and people were giving resistance to her because she was following this knowledge. And people in her own house were doing black magic on her. And she was really frustrated since last 7 years. And at last she reached Madhuban somehow. And she said that I have come here since only 1 week. And only with my meditation and creating good positive thoughts, minds of my family people have already started changing. Because from here she started giving them thoughts. he started passing the good vibrations to them and their mind started changing. And everything in the home has improved, she said. So while sitting in Madhuban, so Baba says, while sitting in Madhuban, you are able to sit and do somewhere and do that. So like I also had an experience 3 years back. I had to go for my brother's wedding. I didn't want to go because I knew that a lot of papers are going to come. And because if you go in a function, they will ask you to eat food. They will ask you to do things what they are doing. And I didn't want to do that. But I had to go for 9-10 days. So I started preparing 1 month before only. Because I always have this faith that if we do something from Madhuban, it happens fast as compared to when we go there and do things. So I started preparing myself 1 month before only that, Baba, I'm not going to touch their food. I'm not going to be the way they are. And you have to take care of this. And I started putting thoughts and vibrations in their mind, in the girl's family and even my parents. So when I went home and we were going for a function in the car, and my mother had packed some food for me, so because I am not going to eat there. And my mother and my elder sister was there, and I said, "Ki, you all have packed the food for me, but what if they ask me, ki, you are not eating here? So it would look so bad, no, if I'll open my tiffin there." So they said, "No, you just tell them your stomach is upset, you are not going to eat." So I started looking at them, what ideas I was using when I came in knowledge. Now they are only speaking that and they are telling me, tell these things to them. Ki, my stomach is upset and I cannot eat outside food, so I am carrying my own food, I'll eat that. And when I went there, nobody, in so many functions, there were 5 functions, none of the people asked me to eat food. In fact, they used to cut fruits for me and they used to say, "You don't eat, no, you eat fruits. Oh, we forgot to make vegetarian food for you," because I come from Muslim background, so all non-veg was there. So they would say, "Oh, we just forgot only to make vegetarian food for you." I said, "No problem." So it was like that. So how we can sit and pass vibrations from here? So Baba says, just as the fragrance of something physically automatically spreads everywhere, similarly, the vibrations of your thoughts should automatically spread everywhere. This is a special service that residents of Madhuban have to do. When you have a special bhatti in Madhuban, those vibrations spread everywhere. So one thing where we can create good thoughts is bhatti. Like when we do bhatti, we all sit with one single thought and then the entire group creates one elevated high energy power thought and that passes to the world. So I was thinking, what could be the other points where our thoughts become elevated? What we should do? So one thing is that we should be deliberately thinking on our thoughts and beliefs. Like we have to be positive in whatever we think. Make a effort in the entire day that we don't do any negative thoughts. Second practice I was thinking, since we discussed about a perfume. Think that there is a perfume bottle here in the center of the forehead. And today if we meet anybody, just spray that vibration of positivity or purity or peace. And if I see her as a soul, and I'll spray that. Today I am giving purity vibrations to her, peace vibrations. So this is what practice we can do in the entire day. Next is, like Bhatti Baba is saying, next is if we are churning the knowledge, then we can give positive energy, then we are in an elevated state. Like Baba gives example of cow. The cow who ruminates is a healthy cow. The cow who doesn't ruminate is an unhealthy cow. So that's why churning of knowledge is very important. And as brother described was happiness today. And yesterday's Murli also, Baba has spoken about unhappiness. Who are unhappy will become servant and maids in golden age. So that's why happiness. So if we are happy, then we give good thoughts to the world. Like this year, WHO's theme, 7th April is WHO Day. And this year's theme is depression, let's talk. So they say, if you are depressed, don't keep things to yourself, but go out and talk to someone. Because when we are unhappy, when we are depressed, we keep on churning the bad thoughts inside. And that negative energy we pass around. So that's why depression, let's talk. So go out and talk. So this is today. And yesterday is one more point. So yesterday Baba told about vacuum cleaner. How a vacuum cleaner is there that you just put a switch on and automatically whatever the rubbish is there, that's attracted towards it. You don't need to go anywhere. So likewise, Madhuban Nivasis can sit in Madhuban and do lot of service. So today you can become one vacuum cleaner, one perfume bottle. Okay? Om Shanti.